What up, B? All right, my feminines. It's a little bit late. I just got out with a client, but I haven't pulled in a long time on here, so we're just gonna give it a whirl. So this is very feminine energy heavy. A lot of fire. So right off the bat, my team is talking about a recent success or fulfillment. They're talking about this being in the emotional state of yourself as so it refers to another. Okay. So it refers to another. So I'm talking about relationships. Got it. So you have emotional fulfillment within a relationship. Now, this does not necessarily have to be outside yourself, but it could be a better relationship with yourself. They're saying it has trickled out into your outer world, though. So they are calling it karmic. This fulfillment has triggered your next beginning. So it is a bit of a phoenix moment for you in that died and rised from the ashes. Now they're saying you're still a little bit stuck in your head, like you don't quite realize that this has already happened. You're waiting for it to happen like it didn't just happen, girl. It already did, is what my team is saying, that you just did that in the later half of last week through the weekend. So they're saying now moving forward, you need to take a observatory stance and look at things from the highest perspective. And they're saying that you need to sit back and show a little patience. And they're saying that you're looking for the next move. And the only way that you're going to see the next path that you want to take, because there is no wrong path, the next one that you want to take, they're saying to look at it from the highest perspective. So really get that aerial view with things. Somebody needs to be reminded that they're the motherfucking Queen of Cups. So somebody is in this lack mindset, maybe a little bit of chaos mindset when it comes to the feminines, or a masculine who is stuck in his feminine. You need to realize that you command that space, that you do it with elegance, and you do it with a very steady emotional hand. They're saying, however, in this new, you're going to be presented with a choice, and it's not going to be an easy choice. They're saying the perception that one answer is wrong is false. It's not a test. The choice is not a test. You will get to the finish line or the goal ending no matter which choice you take. The only thing that's going to be different, they're saying, is the route you go. They're calling it fated. We have the Wheel of Fortune out here. They are calling it fated. They're saying, however, despite which option you choose, or, you know, you're going to lead to the same ending. However, the road you travel will be different. And the things that you learn, the people you pick up, may be slightly different, but it'll be the same lessons through and through. They're saying that this is going to trigger your abundance to hit you kind of in the side of the face full force. And it's also going to start this new beginning for you. So this fiery, passionate, very clear, masterful is what they're calling it, beginning. They're saying that you've already had this brilliant phoenix, and now you're kind of sitting here like, well, shit, what the fuck do I do? You got to take that higher perspective, and they're saying that a choice will be presented to you. You may not see it coming, but when it comes, it will be obvious. So all my feminines, get out of your fucking head. Get out of your head. There's nothing wrong with you, babe. You are fine. Get out of your head. Look at everything. Take the observer seat. Don't be reactive. And sit in patience. your choice will fall in your lap. And then from there, it's yours to choose, but you're going to the same place. Bye.